In this video, we are going to discuss the pin description of 8085 microprocessor. You can observe the pin diagram of 8085 microprocessor. It's a 40 pin IC. The 40 pins are like this. Here you can observe 1 to 20 pins. So from 21 to 40 you are having, so upside down. So that means, so 1 to 20 from top to bottom and 21 to 40 from bottom to top. Now we will discuss each and every pin. Now here you can observe first two pins, that is X1 and X2, which represent crystal oscillator which will provide the frequency for microprocessor. The crystal oscillator frequency is 6 kHz. Half of that, nearly half of that, we are getting for frequency of microprocessor. So that is nearly 3 kHz. Now coming to reset out. So that pin is reset out. This is going to reset the devices connected to microprocessor. Whenever microprocessor is reset mode, then all the devices which are connected to microprocessor are going to reset if reset out is enabled. This is active high signal. Then you can observe 4th and 5th pins are SOD and SID. So SOD means serial output data, SID means serial input data. These two pins, that means 4th and 5th pins of this 8085 microprocessor, are used for serial data communication. So that means serial input data will take input and serial output data will give output of that serial data. And here coming to TRAP, RST 7.5, 6.5, 5.5, INTR and INTA are related to interrupts. These interrupts we will discuss separately in the next classes. So here INTA is interrupt acknowledgement. This is active low signal. That means whenever these interrupts are enabled, then this interrupt acknowledgement will give you zero. That means, so microprocessor will provide active low signal for this INTA bar. Whenever you saw this bar on any of this pin description, that is said to be active low. That means for 0 it is going to process, for 1 it is going to off that operation. So here from 12th pin to 19th pin, those are multiplexed address and data lines. That means, so here from we are having for 8085 microprocessor, so that is 40 pin IC. In that 40 pin IC, from 12 to 19 you can observe AD0 to AD7. So in this, so these are called as multiplex lines. It can do both addressing and data transfer operation. So when they are in lowercase mode, lower mode, then they can transfer address. When they are in uppercase mode, then they can transfer data. That means, so from A0 to totally A15, so we are having 16 address lines and 8 data lines. That 8 data lines are from D0 to D7. This D0 to D7 and in address lines A0 to A7 are multiplexed and they are given as AD0 to AD7. From AD0 to AD7, these are called as address lines and as well as data lines. So these lines are multiplexed. And coming to 20th pin is equivalent to VSS, that means ground. So here for 40th pin, we will discuss 21st pin from bottom to top. So in order, if you want to discuss, you can take 21st pin to 28th pin. So these are called as only address lines, that is from A8 to A15. Coming to 29th pin, this is S0, and in the same way at 33, you can observe S1. So S0 and S1 are status pins. So here we will discuss this S1, S0 and IO and memory later. We are having some theory, important theory related to that. That also we will discuss in next class. So here these S0 and S1 are status pins. And coming to ALE. So latch enable. So whenever this represents, this is active high signal, this represents the status of this address and data lines. So here you are getting some positive signal and negative signal according to the address and the data following here. If address is passing in these lines, then ALE shows one value. So this is, for example, if positive value is there, this is a positive going pulse ALE. So if positive going pulse is there, then address is going in these lines. So if you saw any negative peak, then you can say data is traveling in these lines. So like that, you are having WR. This is write memory or IO write. That means this having bar here. You can observe a bar here. That means this is also a active low signal. Whenever you got active low signal for this WR, then you can say this is write operation. So when write operation memory or IO write is going on, this WR bar will get active low signal, and here RD bar is there. Whenever read operation is going on from IO or memory, then it will get active low signal. And S1 is, we already discussed, that is the status line. And IO or memory, in this read and write operation, which is there, which IO operation is going on or memory operation is going on, that can be described by this pin. That means here you are reading and writing. You can read and write either IO or memory. That means, so here whenever you got one here, that means positive signal, then it will represents IO read or IO write. When you got zero here, as memory is a active low signal, memory will be activated. That means if you want to read or write anything from memory, it should be zero. Then only it will be memory read or write will be activated. Then ready. So here you are having ready. That means here microprocessor is having higher frequency than your peripheral devices connected to this microprocessor. After completion of each task, this is going to provide some ready signal to take another operation. So after completion of every signal, it will be equivalent to 1. After that, you are having reset in. This is a active low signal. That means for 0, if you got 0 there, the microprocessor is going to reset. Reset in is the reset of microprocessor. Reset out is the reset of devices connected to microprocessor. So you can keep it in mind about the difference of reset in and reset out. And here you are having clock signal, which drives another circuits connected to microprocessor, and HLDA, HOLD are also used for timing for other devices. And here this is VCC. VCC may be plus 5 volts or anything, that means supply voltage you can say. So here this is about pin description of 8085 microprocessor. So main things you need to keep in mind is it's having 16 address lines from A0 to A15 and 8 data lines from D0 to D7. From A0 to A7 and D0 to D7 are multiplexed and considered as AD0 to AD7. So here we will discuss these interrupts in the next class. That is all very important. Interrupts are very important in microprocessor. So this is about total pin description of 8085 microprocessor.